tumor.
Cardiac tumors. Cardiac tumor is the primary originator from the heart itself, usually from the site of valve, or there may be metastasized. So there is a tumor we can broadly classified into the rising primarily in the heart and those metastasized from distant sources. Most of the common tumors are primary in the heart. In the primary tumors, we can be classified again in the benign tumors and the malignant tumors. Benign tumors in the heart are more common than the malignant. 80% tumors are benign tumors. But these have presentations like valvular lesions, so they have to know the pathophysiology of the cardiac tumor or identify it adequately, because these may convert it into the malignancy. So when patient with cardiac tumors are present with a variety of symptoms, many patients are asymptomatic at the time of diagnosis, because the tumor usually causes obstruction of the valve, and until unless the obstruction of the valve, there may be asymptomatic. Incidental studies by the imaging studies and the echo, we can use the diagnosis. And this is finding need to be differentiated from other cardiac masses as well, like a we have cymatic presentation with the vegetation, like an infective endocarditis, or there may be a thrombus, or sometimes use myocardial hypertrophy. In the primary tumors, rare, approximately 3/4 are histologically benign. In the benign tumors, most common are the myxoma. Malignant tumor, almost all of these are sarcomas. And all cardiac tumors, regardless of pathology, have the potential to cause life-threatening complications, because they have again chances of thrombus formation. So it may cause the thromboembolism. They have chances to infect vegetation formation, or they have obstruction to the nearby wall. So they may be have chances to life-threatening complication. So clinical presentation: cardiac tumor are present with a variety of cardiac and non-cardiac manifestations. These manifestation depends on the large part of on the location and the size of the tumor, as well as its impacts on the surrounding cardiac structures. Like often non-specific feature are more common: chest pain, syncope, congestive heart failure, murmur, arrhythmia, conduction disturbances, and pericardial effusion, and sometimes in cardiac tamponade. Additionally, embolic phenomena and constitutional symptoms may occur. Usually, whenever there is a chances of tumor in the heart, there is a constitutional symptoms are the only symptoms. Patient may have vague symptoms like a lethargyness, weight loss, fatigue, headache, body ache, palpitation, or sometimes there is a chances of embolization, tumor embolization. If there is a size is large and the location is nearby to the valve, then there is a chances of conduction disturbances, there is a chances of congestive heart failure, obstruction causing a syncope, and sometimes when there is a aortic valve is involved, sometimes patient will present like a myocardial infarction, because there is a obstruction for aortic valve and the nearby coronary arteries. So these symptoms may occur. So whenever we are suspecting cardiac tumors, myxomas are most common tumors. These are the primary tumor arising from the heart, and these occur at all ages, most commonly in the 3rd decade to 6th decade. So after adulthood, there is a chances of myxoma are common. If we see the male-female ratio, is a female is predisposing. Approximately 90% of myxoma are sporadic tumor. they have genetic origin, but there is a no familial tendency. But sometimes there is a familial tendencies with autosomal dominant transmission. So familial varieties are often occur as a part of syndromes, that is known as Karnes complex. That includes myxoma. Usually cardiac myxomas are common, but they have associated with involvement of myxoma in the skin and the breast. On the skin there is a pigmented nevi formations and lentigus. Third, there is endocrine overactivity in the form of primary nodular adrenal cortical disease with or without Cushing syndrome. May have Cushing syndrome or not. Testicular tumor may associate or pituitary adenomas in the form of gynetes or acromegaly. So what we can learn, there is a myxoma, usually common, but Karnes complex should be seen in the form of skin involvement and endocrine involvement. So along with cardiac myxoma, there is a skin is involved in the form of pigmented nevi formation and tight spread of the body. Sometimes there is a lentigens formations in the axilla. Endocrinal activity in the form of adrenal involvement or pituitary gland involved. Adrenal gland is involved in the form of Cushing syndrome, so no or not Cushing syndrome, simple adrenal hyperplasia causing the features of the adrenal cortical hyperplasia. Pituitary involvement in the form of growth hormone, in the form of gynetism or acromegaly. So when we see a patient coming to you with having a visceral formation of the body part in the form of gynetism or acromegaly, gynetism is if there is a childhood age or there is an elderly in the sixth decades, there is maybe a acromegaly. May have some features of the Cushing syndromes. Skin, we look there is a pigmented nevi formation or pigmented skin. And symptoms of the syncope or congestive heart failure may have chances of cardiac myxomas in the tumor. So this is a picture of a patient coming to you like this. Other than Karnes complex, that is common, there may be Lane syndrome or Lamb syndrome. If there is a nevi formation, atrial myxoma. Myxomas are common in the form of atrial myxomas, usually side of left atrium. Myxoma, neurofibroma on the skin, aphalates formation over the skin, and the nevi formation in the atrial myxoma. This is known as Lane syndrome. Another is a Lane syndrome, there is a lentigens, atrial myxoma, and blue nevi. Although these syndromes probably represent subset of the Karnes complex, because Karnes complex has skin involvement in the form of lentigens on the pigmented nevi and the atrial myxoma, along with there is a endocrinal involvement. If there is an endocrinal involvement in the pituitary adrenal or sometimes in the thyroid involvement, then it is not Karnes complex, otherwise it is not named Name and Lane syndrome. What is pathology and formation of myxomas are related in its structure, consists of obviously there is a myxomata cells, that is amblyopia stroma, the glycosome and glycans. And the most tumor are spotic, usually solitary tumors arising from the interatrial septa. The division between the left atria and right atria, there is a septa, there is known as the interatrial septa, that is causes origin of the these type of spotic myxomatous tumor. They grow towards the mitral wall. And are often perunculated under the fibrovascular stalk, and in contrast, in the form of familial that have a tendency to originate in the family this syndromic tumor tend to occur in the more in younger adults. Often multiples and maybe ventricular in location, and are more likely to recur after initial resection, that is, have more chances to convert into the malignancy. The common are the spotic, isolated or solitary, interatrial origin, towards the vicinity of the tetrium, towards the mitral wall, and are often pedunculated by the fibrovascular stalk, usually in the female. Clinical features, myxomas commonly present with obstructive siren symptoms because they have tendency to grow towards the mitral wall. That's why they cause the obstruction of the mitral wall. So symptoms are like a mitral stenosis. So you have to differentiate between the mitral stenosis or the myxoma. Because siren symptoms are sometimes correlate to each other. Most common clinical presentation that mimic with the mitral wall disease. Either stenosis or when the tumor collapses in the mitral orifice or the recurrent lesion sometimes, which would tumor induced valvular tumor or the valvular trauma or the distortion of the annulus of the valve. So they may rarely present with the regurgitation. Usually there is a stenotic lesion type of clinical feature, that is obstructing type of lesion. Ventricular myxomas that have occurred in the familial type of myxomas are the cause of obstruction similar to that caused by the subaortic or subpulmonary, because they cause towards the pulmonary site. The symptoms and sign of myxoma may be sudden in the onset and positional due to the gravity causes changes in position of the tumor. That is a typical sign of tumor rather than mitral wall itself involved. And the characteristic low pitched sound, that is known as tumor plop sound. When we talk about the extra sound of the heart, one is tumor plop, that is low pitch sound, may be appreciated on auscultation during early or mid diastole. So mid diastole means S1, S2, S2, S1. S1, S2 is the systole, S2, S1 is the diastole. So after second heart sound, after some period, in the mid or early time, there is a extra sound that is equal to the S3. At the time of S3, there is another sound that is known as tumor plop sound. Clear? But they have characteristic is just low pitch. They thought to result from the impact of the tumor against the mitral wall or the ventricular wall. In the diastole, the blood is flowing from the mitra to aorta to the ventricles. So atria to ventricles, the blood is flowing. At that time, suddenly the tumor avert the mitral wall or the ventricular wall. That's a create a sound, that is tumor plop sound. Usually present with the peripheral or pulmonary embolic phenomena due to embolization of the tumor fragments or the tumor associated thrombus. Both may be chances. Sometimes itself tumor may embolize, or sometimes there is a vegetation that causes thrombus formation and that may embolize. These causes peripheral involvement. So peripheral embolization causes peripheral siren symptoms. Along with this, constitutional sign and symptom like a fever, weight loss, cachexic, malaise, arthralgia, joint pains, rashes, digital clubbing and Raynaud's phenomena. So these may be sign and symptoms may be seen or not be seen in all the patients of myxomas. So usually in an initial stage, patient comes to you with seen fever, low grade fever, weight loss, joint pain like rheumatic manifestations. When we go deeper in a study, patient complains when he or she walk, there is a tiredness, shortness of breath, palpitation. Mind goes maybe cardiac or respiratory involvement. When we auscultate, there is a plop sound. Tears is similar. Then you have to go for the imagings. Diagnosis, the lab, obviously there is a clinical feature that may suggest like this. And then lab, hyper gamma globulinemia, anemia. Usually these present with anemic patients. Hypoxic, causes polycythemia. Hypoxia causes polycythemia. Patient is anemic. Go for the albumin globulin ratio. There is a reversal of AG ratio in the form of hyper gamma globulinemia. ESR is elevated, TLC is increased, but neutrophil is normal. Elevated CRP and ESR, thrombocytopenia, thrombocytosis may be seen. So all these features is confusing. Another disease, so we have to exclude the disease because in the increased ESR, increased CRP, TLC is raised, anemia, hypergammaglobulinemia, all these suggest inflammatory disease. Anyways, any of the inflammatory disease may have such like of sign as lab findings. But patient have typical clinical feature. So cardiac examination is suggestive of like this picture. You may suspect patient may have a cardiac tumor. These features account for the frequent misdiagnosis in patient with eczema have endocarditis, collagen vascular disease or paraneoplastic syndrome, because these have only the indication of the inflammation. Any inflammation? Collagen vascular disease, connective tissue disease, any other tumors causing paraneoplastic features, or there is infective endocarditis may have some symptoms and the lab findings or such like. So go for 2D echo. Useful in the diagnosis of cardiomyopathic tumors and allow the assessment of the tumor size and determine the tumor and the site of attachment are both which are important for considering planning of the even of the surgical excision also. In the CT and MRI may be provide the important findings like size, shape and composition and surface characteristic of the tumors. Although cardiac catheterization and angiography previously performed routinely before tumorization, but no longer required because non-invasive modality is sufficient to diagnose and categorize the tumor before going to surgical excision. So tumor have to excise is the only definite treatment. Using the cardiovascular bypass. Myxomas recur in the 12% cases in the family cases, but only 1-2% in the sporadic cases. And the common is sporadic, so there are less chances of recurrence once there is a rejection. So tumor recurrence most likely results due to the multifocal lesions or the incomplete rejection. In the next class, we will plan to treat other benign tumors.